If you look at the top selling airplanes in the world, you will find the Boeing 737 in the second rank and the Airbus A320 in the third. Today we're checking into the world of narrowbody, single-aisle commercial jetliners to explore the key differences between two giants in the industry, the Airbus A320 and the Boeing 737. Hello aviation enthusiasts, welcome back to Aviation by Ali. The first Airbus 320 was delivered to Air France on 28th of March 1988. The early Airbus 320-100 had no wingtip fences. The Boeing 737 is one of the highest produced commercial aircraft in history. Envisioned in 1964, the initial 737-100 made its first flight in April 1967 and entered service in February 1968 with Lufthansa. Let's kick things off with a look at the manufacturers. The Airbus A320 is proudly crafted by Airbus, a European aerospace powerhouse, while its counterpart, the Boeing 737, takes its origins from the renowned American aerospace company, Boeing. Moving on to the heart of this aircraft, the cockpit. The Airbus 320 and 737 showcase distinct cockpit layouts. The Airbus 320 boasts a sleek side stick control, while the Boeing 737 goes for the classic yoke design. In the realm of flight control philosophy, the Airbus 320 embraces a sophisticated fly-by-wire system, transmitting electronic control inputs from the pilot to the surfaces. Meanwhile, the Boeing 737 opts for a more traditional mechanical control system. Let's talk power. Both aircraft offer various engine options, but specifics can vary. The Airbus 320 neo introduces fuel-efficient engines, and the Boeing 737 MAX series follow suit, providing cutting-edge propulsion technology. A step inside, and you will notice a difference in cabin width. The Airbus A320 treats passengers to a wider cabin, offering a more spacious interior that can significantly impact comfort compared to the Boeing 737. If you found this comparison insightful, do not forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more aviation content. Airlines enjoy flexibility in configuring interiors, yet dimensions and design differ. Seating arrangements and amenities vary, reflecting the unique preferences and needs of each airline's passengers. When it comes to capacity, specifics depend on the model and configuration. The Airbus 320 and 737 may differ, but they generally fall within a similar range for standard configuration. Now let's soar into range and performance. A specific model with the Airbus 320 and 737 families offer varied capabilities. Airlines make strategic choices based on operational needs, such as range, requirements, and fuel efficiency. The short to medium range Airbus 320 is the most popular version, with a range of about 3,300 nautical miles or 6,150 kilometers. It is offered in four main variants, typically offering 138 to 230 seats and a range of 3,215 to 3,825 nautical miles. These giants have been produced in abundance, competing fiercely for market share in the single-aisle commercial aircraft segment. The popularity of specific models can fluctuate based on customer preferences and market conditions. Let's break down a comparison between the Airbus 320 and the Boeing 737 in terms of their market performance, crash statistics, production numbers, and the variety of types within each family. Airbus A320 for market performance. The Airbus 320 has gained significant market share, especially in the single-aisle commercial aircraft segment. It's popular among the airlines worldwide, with many carriers choosing the Airbus 320 family for its efficiency and modern features. As of January 2024, a total of 18,460 Airbus 320 family aircraft had been ordered and 11,289 delivered, of which 10,584 aircraft were in service with more than 350 operators. The global Airbus 320 fleet had completed more than 172 million flights over 319 million blocks hour since its entry into service. But in other hand, for Boeing 737, which has historically one of the best-selling commercial aircraft globally, it has a strong presence in the market and has been a go-to choice for many airlines for decades. As of January 2024, 16,460 Boeing 737 have been ordered and 11,685 delivered. Initially, its main competitors was the McDonnell Douglas DC-9, followed by the MD-80 or MD-90 derivatives. In 2013, the global 737 fleet had completed more than 184 million flights over 264 million block hours since its entry into service. What about crashes? The Airbus 320 family, like any aircraft, has experienced various incidents and accidents over the years. The following is a list of accidents and incidents involving the Airbus 320 family and Airbus A320neo family of jet airliners. As of January 2024, 180 aviation accidents and incidents have occurred, including 38 hull loss accidents and a total of 1,505 fatalities in 17 fatal accidents. However, the Boeing 737 has also encountered accidents and incidents throughout its operational history. As of October 2023, there has been a total of 504 aviation accidents and incidents involving all 737 aircraft, including 219 hull losses resulting in a total of 5,717 fatalities. However, Airbus and Boeing have continuously worked on improving safety features, and the overall safety record is in line with the industry standards. We also already made a video about flight maintenance checks that play a crucial role in flight safety. I invite you to watch that video too. Both the Airbus 320 and 737 families have four different variants within each type, offering airlines flexibility based on their operational needs and passenger capacity requirements. The Airbus 320 family includes various versions, such as the Airbus 318, Airbus 319, Airbus 320 and Airbus 321, contributing to its overall production numbers. While on the other hand, for Boeing 737, its production spans several generations, including the original 737, the Classic Series, Next Generation NG, and the Last Max Series. But how to recognize them from outside? Recognizing the specific model of an aircraft from the outside can be challenging for someone who is not an aviation enthusiast or professional. However, there are some general visual cues that can help differentiate between the Airbus 320 and the Boeing 737. First, look at the wingtip fins. The Airbus 320 typically has distinctive wingtip fins on the end of its wings. There are upward curving structures that help improve aerodynamics performance. Older version of the Airbus 320, known as the Airbus 320 CEO, current engine option, may not have winglets. Winglets are vertical extensions at the tip of the wings. However, newer versions like the Airbus 320 NEO new engine option, often come equipped with winglets. While many Boeing 737 aircraft, especially the newer 737NG, Next Generation, and MAX series, feature distinctive winglets at the tips of the wings, but these winglets can upward curving or blended. The wingtips of the Boeing 737 are often more squared or flattened compared to the wingtips of the Airbus 320. The next feature is about being single aisle. Both the Airbus 320 and 737 are single aisle aircraft, but the Airbus 320 tends to have a wider cabin. The wider fuselage can contribute to a slightly different overall appearance compared to the 737. The other feature is about tail cone shape. The tail cone of the Boeing 737 tends to have a different shape compared to the Airbus 320. The tail cone on the 737 is often more angular. But personally, I think the main important feature for recognizing between these two popular aircraft is the engine shape. The Boeing 737 has a unique engine shape that sets it apart not just from the Airbus A320, but from most other planes too. Unlike other planes with round engines, the 737 engines have a flat bottom, making the opening look more stretched or oval shaped. In contrast, Airbus planes have engines that are perfectly round. The last difference is nose shape. Some people may not use this feature as a main way to distinguish between planes, but for those who do, here is a tip. The Airbus nose is shorter and rounder, while the Boeing nose is more pointed. As a little extra detail, take a look at the front landing gear doors. The Airbus seems to cover a big part of the door when closing, whereas the Boeing keeps the entire door open during landing. Keeping in mind that these visual cues are generalization and may not apply to every variant within the Airbus 320 and 737 families. Additionally, airline liveries, paint schemes, and specific modifications. Specific modifications can further complicate visual identification. Aviation enthusiasts often become familiar with these details through experience and observation. If you are unsure about a specific aircraft model, you can check with the aviation professionals, online database, or use mobile apps that provide real-time information on aircraft types and registration. In conclusion, both Airbus A320 and Boeing 737 families have undergone numerous updates, incorporating advanced technologies and improved efficiency. Airlines carefully consider factors like fuel efficiency, operating cost, and fleet compatibility when selecting between these industry stalwarts.